your speech. So next speakers from Japanese side would be Mr. Shigetaka Nakanishi. He's a senior reservoir engineer of J-Power. His entire career, spanning over 40 years, has been engaged in geothermal project as a reservoir engineer. So he is currently served as the first representative of the reservoir geothermal power corporation in 2010 to 2015, which is still under development of geothermal power plant. The scale is 42 megawatt project. So, okay. So he would come into the you know project in the speech. So please.
Thank you, Otomaru-san. Good morning, everyone. I'd like to thank, first of all, I'd like to thank GNS Science and JOGMEC for giving me an opportunity to talk about our developing field. This morning, I'd like to talk about the newly developing field in Japan named Wasabizawa and Akinomiya field. This is my outline of my talk. First, I'd like to talk about the Wasabizawa Akinomiya geothermal system, and then I'll talk about a little bit about numerical reservoir simulation for estimating the electrical capacity, and then. I'll talk about monitoring. And finally, I'll talk about the stakeholder engagement for local community and hot spring owners. This is a background of the Wasabizawa project. The location of the field is at the northeastern part of Japan, in Akita Prefecture, the southernmost area of the Akita Prefecture in Yuzawa City. Here, Wasabizawa and Akinomiya field. Here is the Uenotai geothermal power station producing the electricity since 1994. NEDO, Japanese governmental agency, supported the geothermal development promotion survey for Wasabizawa area and for adjacent Akinomiya area. After NEDO surveys, these areas were transferred to J-Power and MMC, Mitsubishi Material Corporation. Over time, it became evident that Wasabizawa and Akinomiya represent of the a single larger geothermal reservoir. So J-Power and MMC started a joint exploration. And also we start the hot spring monitoring program since then. After, along with the feasibility study, J-Power and MMC and MZC, Mitsubishi Gas and Chemical Corporation, jointly established the Yuzawa Geothermal Power Corporation, YGP, to manage the resource and to accelerate the exploration work for both area in a unified manner. So since then, YGP has been leading the project, and we performed the environmental impact assessment in this here. So this figure shows the exploratory well location map. In this area, over 30 exploratory wells have been drilled so far, and the reservoir character is relatively well delineated by extensive exploration. This is a representative temperature profile. This figure shows that the conduction dominated phenomena are shown in the shallower in a impermeable caprock area. But the caprock may extend down to the level of the plus 200 meter above sea level between 200 plus 200 and minus 200 meter above sea level. And below that depth, conduction dominated reservoir extend with a temperature of the 280 degrees C and 290 degrees C. This is a pressure profile. Elevation of feed point of the wells and feed point pressure here. This figure shows that almost all wells drop in the single hydrostatic pressure gradient line, except two wells. AY pressure of AY5 and YO8 apparently 10 megapascal lower than the others. So this shows that the nearly impermeable barrier exists between the two wells and the others. And also Akinomiya hot spring, these two wells are located near the Akinomiya hot spring area. This is an infrared temperature distribution at minus 500 meters above sea level. The reservoir may be extend around here. And here is the Akinomiya hot springs. To the southwest of the field, the temperature decreases sharply. And the location of the YO8 and AY5 is located here near the Akinomiya hot springs. So maybe they are the nearly impermeable barrier around there. To the northeast of the field, here is a Kawarage fumarole area and Doroi hot spring there. And nearby Uenotai power station is around, located here. I'll show you the next cross section around this line. So I'd like to point out here that the reservoir located around here consists of the fracture network naturally developed in the basement rock, mainly ground diorite. And here is the Akinomiya hot spring over here. And in the Kawarage Himarole area, volcanic gases and high acidic hot spring caused by dissolution of the gas discharging here in the relatively low temperature area. These facts show that the Wasabizawa reservoir is maybe the hydraulically disjoint from the nearby Uenotai geothermal resources, and also the Kawarage fumarole area, and also Doroi hot spring. So next, I'll talk about a numerical reservoir simulation. We took a 7 kilometers and 8 kilometers for numerical simulation. This yellow color shows the NEDO's survey area. And the total block number is here, but this area is has a highly irregular elevation. So void grid block is number is here, so active grid blocks number is almost 10,000. This is a cross section. You see the highly irregular topography. And the rock property, other than permeability, were fixed in the simulation, numerical simulation. And the spatial distribution of the absolute permeability were treated as unconstrained parameter, a free parameter from case to case to improve the quality of the data match. These are final result of the set of horizontal permeability and vertical permeability assigned for various formation. Available data from drilling indicate that the formation are permeable. Where formation are permeable, the permeability arises from the presence of fracture that penetrate the impermeable country rock. So we use the so-called conductive mink assembly to represent the non-equilibrium heat transfer between impermeable country rock matrix and permeable fracture zone. Here, a yellow color zone, that the computational grid rock represents the matrix block and outer fracture zones. And yellow color shows the matrix block subdivided into the 31 concentric spherical shape. And outer red zone represents the fracture zone. In this assembly, the average fracture spacing is the diameter of the spherical assembly. So we took, in the best case, we took a average fracture spacing 550 meters. So in the natural state simulation, the calculation performed during for 200,000 years. This is a summer energy change in the 200,000 years. And final stage, the system is entirely stable and steady. So in this natural state simulation, this is the final case, the result of the final case of the simulation and the comparison between the measured field zone pressure and calculated value. The yellow shows the measured pressure and the green shows the computed pressure. And the matching is satisfactory. This is a result, a comparison between the calculated temperature and measured temperature profile at each well. So red is calculated and yellow shows the actual measurement. So we could get a satisfactory matching. And the final, for the final numerical model, that model was employed in the field-wide pressure interference test. This is an example of the pressure interference test at AY2 and AY8 in the production test of the 3 months production test. The black one is measured pressure and red one is computed value from the final natural state model. So matching is again satisfactory. So after we obtain the natural state model, we performed several forecast calculations. This shows the base case geometry of the future performance calculation. We took a production area for at the Wasabizawa area and reinjection area, Akinomiya field area. And red one showed the hypothetical monitoring well. And we studied several megawatt capacity and several plant type. And base case, we took a 30 megawatt single flash plant. And another case, we compared the result. This is an example of the result, the drilling requirement. For base case, single flash 30 megawatt case, the initially 6 wells, production wells were required. And due to the production capacity decline, the megawatt well is required after 17 years and 31 years and 48 years of operation. This is a 50 years operation calculation. So this best case, single flash 30 megawatt scenario is a sustainable development scenario. On the other hand, the black one, this is single flash 45 megawatt case. The production requirement is rapidly increased after 20 years operation. This is because the substantial pressure decline at the production horizon causes a partial dryout that result in the average discharge entropy increase after 20 years operation. So that case is not good, sustainable. The red one show the final now plant 42 megawatt case. So should be no problem, this scenario. Oh, this is a evolution of temperature distribution. So it appears that cold reinjected water from the Akinomiya well field will not influence the production entropy even after many years of operation. So numerical simulation, a numerical model has been constructed for this area, which is conservative in character and in good agreement with available measurement from the field. So calculation based upon the model indicate that the field can sustain more than 42 megawatt for more than 50 years. So next, I talk hot spring. Monitoring. We have started a monitoring program since June 2009, when we started the exploratory drilling. And the 13 hot spring and 1 water sampling. We share the data with hot spring owners and local government. Yuzawa City. There are various types of the hot springs, natural discharge, or pumped up, or natural fumarole area. So stakeholder engagement. We have started the stakeholder engagement program since we started the exploration. That involved the timely local community meeting or a site visiting tour or communication, cross communication with the hot spring owners. So this activity made possible to build trust in a relationship with local resident. This photograph shows the local committee meeting. The hot spring area is separated, the west and east, so the meeting was held timely and twice a day, and each area. This photograph shows the visiting site visiting tour. We expect that local people feel close to the power station by such a tour. We have also received the local government support listed here. And for example, this Yuzawa City set up an advisory panel of local community to provide us an opportunity to keep a channel of communication open. This photograph shows that meeting, and Mr. Tsutomu Suga from Yuzawa City, he will make a presentation this afternoon. So I'll stop here on the local government support. So in conclusion, what have we learned? First, correct understanding of subsurface geothermal system is required for not only for sustainable development, but also stakeholder engagement. Extensive and continuous stakeholder engagement is required for building trust in a relationship with local community and for successful implementation project. And monitoring is essential. The monitoring involves continuous hot spring monitoring and also the various monitoring for reservoir performance after plant startup. We plan to perform monitor the reservoir pressure at the observation wells and microseismic monitoring and surface microgravity monitoring. I think I understand that this technique has been developed originally in New Zealand. And production fluid monitoring. And finally, local government's role is important in establishing a symbiotic relationship between our developer and local residents, including hot spring owner. So YGP's new Wasabizawa geothermal power station is under construction. This photograph shows some example of the flow test, short flow test. We got a production well. The capacity is more than our expectation. So commercial operation of the plant will begin in 2019. So that's all. my presentation. Thank you very much for your attention.